So welcome to the session of Unix. Today we will discuss the concept of the operating system Unix. So just like the window, Unix is a famous operating system. Now I explain what is Unix. Unix is a completely command based operating system. What is the meaning of command? The meaning of command, you just use command to execute any work of operating system. There is no graphical user interface. So Unix is totally command based operating system. If you see Linux, you heard about the Linux. Linux is a graphical user interface operating system. Graphical user interface operating system means, suppose you want to play music, suppose you want to listen to music, suppose you want to play video file. So you can just, you can't run a command for that. Obviously, there is a graphical user interface. By a mouse, by a keyboard, you can play music. But in Linux, there is no such interpretation of keyboards and just mouse. You have to play music. If you play the music, definitely you go by a command. So this is the difference between the command-based operating system and the graphical user interface operating system. I'm giving a little bit example, just the window. In Windows operating system, you see, if you want to play music, then you just go to the that folder and click the song, and this music will play. But there is a version of Windows is called DOS, disk operating system. This is completely command based operating system. And you can't use the mouse, you can't use the keyboard to play the music. So this is the basic difference of the command based operating system and the graphical use GUI and the command based operating system. So now I'm exploring what is the difference between the Unix and the Linux. Today you see there is a lot of flavor available in Linux, and if you see there is a lot of flavor available in Linux. What is the difference between the flavor and the versions? Flavor. Flavor means a different company produced same operating system. This is called the flavor. Same company produced a same operating system. This is called version. Suppose you see the Windows. Windows 98, Windows 95, Windows 2000, Vista. This is a version because all is produced by a Microsoft. But if you see the Linux, Linux is a open source software system. What is the meaning of open source software system? So I'm writing some concept. Open source operating, open source software system. So what is the meaning of open source software system? The meaning of open source software system is this. If you are registered user of Red Hat, suppose this is a Linux version. If you are registered user of the Red Hat, definitely Red Hat provided a complete source code of Red Hat Linux. Means you can modify that source code according to your business plan. Means if your business requirement is such that you can modify your source code. So you can modify a new operating system. This is called the open source software system. But in Windows, you can't do that. In Windows, you just purchase the window, but you can't modify it according to your business plan. So this is the difference between the open source software system. Okay, let's go. Let's move the next topic. So that's why it is a very great operating system. We can say that Unix is a very big and very great operating system. So it has a different flavors. So I'm again describing the Unix and Linux. Definitely the first invention is based on the Unix, and Unix is a completely command based. There is no graphical user interface. But if you see the Linux, this is a complete GUI based. But as well as there is a GUI available, but you can do the work with the use of command user interface. Same, if you see the current scenario, Unix is also available. Unix is also available. Command user interface plus graphical user interface. So that both type flavors, Unix and Linux, both facilities, just the graphical user interface as well as the command user interface. Now I'm describing there are lot of flavors available in Unix. First flavor is BSD, Berkeley Software Distribution. So the very famous distribution of Unix, this is developed by the California University, that's why it is called is Berkeley Software Distribution. This is a very famous Unix distributions, and the come to the next, this is also the Unix. And next company is called IBM, which is developed the Unix is called AIX. The name of the operating system is AIX. This is also the Unix operating system developed by the company IBM. This is also the another flavor of Unix. And I am describing the next. This is called the company name is HP, and developed Unix system is called UX. Means the company HP developed a Unix operating system with name UX. So I am coming the last one, fourth, and this is called the Sun, SUSE. This is one of the operating system which is developed by the Sun Microsystem. So etc, there are a lot of Unix operating system which is developed by a lot of companies. So this is the description about the Unix operating system. Now if you see the Linux has a lot of flavor. This is the graphical user interface as well as a command user interface, but it has a lot of flavor, means a lot of company developed the same Linux operating system in different configuration. So I am giving the some names here. So this is the one. If you see, the very famous operating system is Red Hat. So Red Hat produced a operating system. This is called Linux. One is operating system. I'm explaining the again. The second very famous name is Ubuntu. This is also a Linux flavor. And third one is like this. SUSE. This is very famous name operating system, and etc, etc. Because if you see, there are more than 600 kernel available in Linux. So we have majorly different two category. One is a Unix and second is a Linux. Okay, now just if you see, if you observe disk operating system DOS, if you observe Windows operating system, if you observe Linux, if you observe Unix, if you install Linux, if you install Windows, there is a file system. What is the meaning of file system? So important question is this: what is the meaning of file system? If you download the Unix, download the Windows, and you install in your system, what is the meaning of file system? So I am explaining, because the file system is an important topic in your syllabus, so I am describing a little bit more. So what is the meaning actually? If you see, each and every operating system is a software. What is software? So I am explaining in terms of software, what is the working of operating system. So each, suppose Unix. What is Unix? Unix is a software. If you see, the software has a lot of files. Suppose you are using the Oracle database, suppose you are using the SQL database, there are a lot of files. If there are a lot of files, the next question is how to arrange it. This is a very basic question. If you see the Unix, this is a 2GB, 3GB file software. If it is a 2GB, 3GB software, so you can't put in a file. You have a lot of variety of files. Because you are arranging a file in systematic manner, because if we are using the system, I am using the hard disk, I am using the device driver, I am using the video files, I'm using the text file. If you just observe, there are a lot of works. So you can't put all the data in single file. This is not a file system. So what is the file system? According my requirement, I will make a different segments of file and put in a order. Then this will make a file system. Okay, so this is clear. So why we make a file system? Because we have a lot of pieces of information and all informations are different category. If all different category informations put in a one place, it will create a problem. So definitely we will make a different folder and arrange in a systematic order and make a file system. So now I am writing why do we need file system. The basic question is this, because most of the, if you are studying about any topic, just you are focusing, this is a question and this is the answer. No. Why this is required? This is my basic first question. Why this is required? Why the file system is required? So I am again, because each and every OS is a software. Means a big information. A big information. So what is the meaning of information here? Big data. So we can't place data in one place. Why we can't place data in one place? So because we have different kind, we have different kind data. So what will be the solution? The solution is, we will make a room for same data. Again, we will make a room for same data. Again, we will make a room for same data, similar kind of data. So this is called the room number 1. This is called the room number 2. And this is called the room number 3. And in order, I can arrange all rooms and make a house. That's why this is called a file system. So first of all, you are very familiar about the Windows. You are very familiar about the DOS, disk operating system. If you see the DOS, DOS is completely command based interface. Means you never use them just like the, you want to write a text in a file. So you don't just go to the via MS Office and click the Office file and just write down the text. So you have to use what? You have to use command based interface. You just write down the command, then file will be open and then you can write some data here. Okay? But if you see the DOS has also a lot of files, a lot of file configuration like the FAT32. If you see the Windows also have a file system like NTFS, Win32, FAT32, FAT16. It is also a file system. But you observe the Unix or Linux. Unix or Linux has also a very, very different kind of file system. Suppose ext16, ext32, ext64. But nowadays, Unix and Linux using the ext64. So nowadays, ext64. This is a common configuration which are used by the Linux and Unix. Okay. So, the basic question is cleared, why we using a file system. But now my question is this, Linux, just if you see the Linux and Unix use the ext64. Okay, just see some basic property of also operating system like this. ext64, this is a file configuration, a file system configuration. But now, if you see the Unix, Unix file system is based on root file system. But if you see the Windows, so I can differentiate Unix as well as Windows, because Windows is a very familiar operating system to users. So I can differentiate what is the difference between Unix and Windows. If you see the Windows, in Windows, you just see C colon, D colon, E colon. So generally you can see in a hard disk is divided in terms of C colon, D colon, E colon. Means if you want to search some music file, definitely you have to go C, and then you have to go music folder, and then you have to go your some song dot mp4 file. So this is one of the path of your song in window. Some another user want to search a video file, suppose, which is belongs to A drive, then definitely I have to go first of all E as a root, then suppose just go video file, and then go to suppose video1.mpb. There is a name, some kuch, there is a, some name, I don't know, remember. So there is a, and there is a another path for my video file. Okay, but if you see for the my mp4 file, there is a another path is called p1, but there is a, for video file there is a path called p2. So for the two searching, we have a two different path or two different file configuration. Means there is, here is a root of C and the here is a root of E. But in Unix, each and everything is start from root. This is called the root configuration. Means what is the root? Means if I want to search anything in the Unix, I want to search any file in the Unix, I have to start from root. What is the meaning of root? Root is a god of that operating system. Means root is a super user of that operating system. So if I am working in Linux flavor, I am working in Unix flavor, what is the meaning? Each and every file stored in a configuration is called the tree configuration, and the parent of the tree is root. And the some basic interesting aspect in Linux is each and every file treated as each and every device treated as file. What is the meaning of this? So I am just writing here, each device, each text, each audio, video, each and everything treated as file. If I am working in directory means folder. In Windows, the folder term is very familiar. But if I am working in Linux and Unix flavor, definitely I will be use the word directory. Directory means folder. In Unix, folder is also treated as file. Video file is also treated as file. Audio is also treated as file. And suppose your hard disk is also treated as file, your CD-ROM, floppy disk, your cache, each and everything is treated as file. So the Unix is completely working on which? Files. So definitely there is a very big role of Unix to arrange each and everything in terms of file. So the file management is a basic big philosophy in Unix and Linux. So just if you see, in Unix, the root is the parent of your tree. If root is the parent of your tree, what is the meaning? Meaning is this, you can start each and everything with the root. Suppose after the root, there is a lot of directory available in Linux configuration. The first famous directory in Linux configuration is win. What is the meaning of win? Win for binary. Win stands for binary. Means all command related, some specific command related information belongs to bin folder. What is this forward slash? This forward slash denoted this is a root. So each directory is just represented via some root configuration, because if I want to search bin, I have to start the searching from root. That's why I am first apply forward slash notation here. So this is the bin folder. So what is the bin folder? Bin folder stands from binary information, means executable information. So what is the executable information? Means some specific command related information are in bin folder. So the operating system directly search that information from the bin folder and use for their in own purpose. That's why the bin binary information is placed on the bin folder. Come to the next folder. Come to the next file. So the next file is DEB. It's a very, very important file. It's called device file. And it means if you are working on the computer, there are a lot of devices. Suppose you are using the hard disk, you are using the cache, I'm using the physical memory. So in the operating system, there are a lot of areas where we are using the devices. So the all device related information means all device related device drivers. So all device drivers are placed in one place and make a file is called the dev file. Whenever you working on the hard disk, then the computer, then the Unix or Linux operating system will just fetch the device driver from the DEV folder and will make it for use. So just this is the dev folder where I can place all the device driver, device drivers information. Okay. Come to the next folder. So after dev file, I can see there is a home. What is the meaning of home? If you see the Windows application, in the Windows operating system, there is a some user. If you install the Windows operating system, there is a requirement, just username, hana, just your password, all that. So if I'm installing the operating system, definitely I am the user of that operating system. So there is a home for that user. Okay. So this is the home for that user, where you can see inside the home, there are a lot of directory. Inside the home, there are a lot of directory and it completely belongs to user. And it completely belongs to user. It completely belongs to user. So the user related information is placed in this folder is called home. Now just coming to the next directories. Okay, home. So this is a some is called etc. ETC stands for the some system configuration file. It is a very big topic actually. This what is a system configuration file. Suppose I want to configure some additional device in my computer, there is a need of system configuration file. So all the system configuration file is just placed in the one place is called ETC folder, and means this is coming from the root. That's why always in every directory I am placing the forward slash. This is the basic meaning. So this is my etc folder. Upcoming lectures I will elaborate in more detail what is the etc, what is the home folder. Actually for the your exam point of view purpose, this is sufficient for the if I am explaining this is a system configuration file, this is a sufficient to you. Okay, now the next folder is called media folder. What is the meaning of media folder? The meaning of media folder is this. Suppose I am connecting a pen drive in my computer. But if you see that my pen drive is a removable disk. Removable disk means sometimes I am adding, sometime I am inserting, sometime I am removing. That's why it is called removable disk. That's why removable disk is not placed in this DEB folder. Because sometimes it is available, sometimes it is not available. So what is the meaning of media? All the removable disk related information is placed in one place is called media folder. So this is the basic meaning of the media folder. If I am inserting four pen drives in my system, definitely all four pen drive related information will go this media folder. So this is the basic working of the media folder. This is the basic functionality of the media folder. I'm coming the next. This is very important. This is called the boot folder. What is called the boot folder? If you see, installation of the operating system is not sufficient. Why? Because you are installing the operating system means just you are placing the operating system in the hard disk, nothing else. What next? If you switch on the computer, definitely some important file which is also available in the hard disk will be placed on the RAM. Then the whole operating system will be placed on the RAM. This is the basic purpose of the boot file. So all boot related file is placed in one place is called boot file or boot directory or boot folder. This is also a file. I have just told you that each and every directory just treated as file. So this is also directory, but it is treated as file. So all boot related information is placed in one place. So the next is, suppose swin. The order may be different to different in different books, but I am randomly prefer one order actually. So if I am considering the swin, what is the meaning of swin? S stands for system, bin for binary, means all system related binary files are placed in one folder. This is called the swin, system bin. Okay, now one very important folder is USR. USR stands for user, and this is also the forward slash is stands for the root. USR. What is the meaning of USR? Suppose you know the Linux or Unix is a multitasking and multi-using operating system. In the upcoming lecture, I will discuss what is the multitasking and the multi-user operating system. How can we differentiate from the Windows? So definitely, this is a very, very big question, and this is a very, very interesting question to all of you. Then you always differentiate Unix with Windows. How Unix has a different functionality from the Windows? This is the basic questions to all of you. If you compare Windows or Unix all the time, definitely you have a great look to feel how Unix is different from the Windows. This is the basic question. So all the time I will compare Unix operating system with Windows operating system. Okay, but if you see the USR folder, the USR folder means user. I'm just explaining, so just write down this point in your copy. Unix is a multitasking and multi-user operating system. In next upcoming lecture, I'm differentiate how can we say that a operating system is multitasking and multi-user, and practically I can prove you that what is multitasking and the multi-user. If you see the USR, and suppose Linux is a multi-using and multitasking operating system. What is the meaning of multi-user? Multi-user means this: simultaneously more than one user can log in at same time. But in Windows you can't do that. But in Linux you can do. Simultaneously 5, 6, 7 users log in at same time. If you think about them a little bit, suppose 6 persons are available and working in the same CPU, means same Linux, same operating system, same hard disk, and all are currently available. What is meaning? You have to maintain a different account to all user. For different user, it has a different account. For different user, it has a different account. For a different user, it has a different account. Means there are 6 or 7 accounts at the same time. This is the responsibility of operating system. This is the responsibility of operating system. This is the responsibility of the operating system. So definitely you have to maintain a directory, a separate directory for that, because for each user there is a file. For in each user, there is a file. For six users, there are six files. So we have to maintain a different directory for six files. This is called a USR file. So all the system related, all the user related information belongs to this USR. Maybe in this directory, there is a lot of work actually. I am describing a very little bit, but there are a lot of information for each directory actually. So remember that. I am not describing the complete scenario of each directory. I mean, just describing a little bit information regarding to your exam point of view. Say, suppose there are another some kind of information is also there. Suppose this is PROC. PROC. What is the meaning of PROC? PROC meaning is the process related information. Means, if you are working on the operating system, each and every time you are creating some processes. If I am creating some processes, what is the meaning? What is meaning? If you are creating the processes, means you have to maintain a file for that process. Means, what will be the process ID? What will be the parent ID? What will be the init process? Definitely. So, you have to maintain the process information in separate files, and all separate files is kept on the one place is called the prop folder. So there is a lot of folders is also available in practically in some Linux my system. I can show you the all live. I can show you all the directory in front of my computers. So that place I just can explore in more detail in this directory. So this is a rough view actually. This is a rough view and some directories also which is not writing here actually. I can show you in my system. So this is a basic philosophy of our computer, course. And in next lecture, line by line, I can elaborate in detail. So thank you.